Hello, my name is Gabby and welcome back to my channel, or if you're new here, then welcome to my channel, and in today's video I'm going to be doing my August wrap-up and then also my September TBR. Also, side note, I know I said I was planning this video for a Monday upload, but I just really needed a couple days to not only get this video ready, but also just get prepared for my college semester. So my plans have definitely been turned upside down recently, but we're here now and we're just gonna get started here. So I started out August really strong. I was feeling really good about reading. I was enjoying it. I was like in my prime level of love for it. And then we had a bad storm that knocked the power out for 4 days, and that's where things went wrong, I think, because all I was doing was reading, and then it felt really old pretty quickly. And ever since then, and we're looking at like about mid-August here, I have been in just like a huge reading slump, and that basically single-handedly destroyed my TBR for August. So the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna talk about all of the books that I actually did read in August, and then I'll transition into the books that I started but never finished because of my reading slump, and then I'll go into my September TBR. So the first three books that I finished in August are Fairy Tail Volumes 3, 4, and 5, all by Hiro Mashima. This is a manga that follows one of our main characters, Lucy, who is a celestial wizard who wants to join the powerful wizard guild Fairy Tail, and it basically follows their adventures. I'm not going to talk about these too much because I've already gone into detail on my channel about just like how much I love these and how much they meant to me for just such a long time. I definitely do feel like I've been talking about this series a lot recently, so I'm just going to say all three of these got 5 stars, and let's just move on now. So after those three, that basically starts the Avatar Last Page Turner readathon, and I will leave links to the vlogs that I did for that readathon down in the description below if you're interested in those, but the first book that I read for that is Felix Ever After by Kacen Callender. So this follows our main character Felix, and one day an anonymous student starts to send him transphobic messages. Felix plans to get revenge, however his catfish scheme accidentally lands him in like a quasi-love triangle. It's a story about a transgender teen as he grapples with identity and self-discovery, all while falling in love for the first time. So this is literally the only book from August that had any luck at all. It held my attention and kept me engaged, which I really appreciated. There were many characters that I liked in here, but I especially really loved our main character Felix, and I also just absolutely adored the romance in here. There were also conversations in here regarding sexual identity and gender and race and class representation, and probably more than that. Overall, this was a very easy 5 stars for me, and I am very excited to read more in Kacen Callender in the future. So next I have Fairy Tail Volume 6, 7, 8, and 9. Once again, these all got 5 stars, and these were what mostly ended up entertaining me during that power outage after I finished Felix Ever After. So next I have The Raizukiyoshi by F.C. Yi, and then this also features Michael Dante DiMartino, who is one of the co-creators of Avatar The Last Airbender. This is a book that takes place in the Avatar The Last Airbender universe, and it follows the origin story of Avatar Kyoshi. So I also read this for the readathon, however this time, unlike Felix Ever After, I ended up really struggling with this, unfortunately. It was the beginning and also just the peak of my reading slump. And also because I didn't want to end up failing the readathon, I pretty much just had to read through it, which did not help this book in any way or any shape or any form. Which does make me so sad because I love Avatar The Last Airbender, and I do think that I would have loved this if I had just read it at a different time. Like, I definitely may reread this at some point in the future. I just thought that this book brought a lot of good things. There were parts of it that did feel like they were 5 stars for me, and then other parts that probably would have been 5 stars if, you know, I actually felt like reading it. I did go ahead and give this 4 stars because objectively, I do feel like it's a good book, but it's just my enjoyment level was just so low that I just can't give it the 5 yet. So that was the last book that I finished in August, so we're gonna go into what I'm currently reading now. I tried to experiment with just like a lot of different books just to see if I could find something that would shake me out of my slump. I will say that I do feel like I am slowly coming out of it, but I'm just not too sure yet or confident in that statement, but I hope so. So the first book is Far as the Souls by Laurie M. Lee. This follows our main character who is training to become the Queen's next spy, however this is all interrupted when her best friend is killed. Our main character is then revealed to be a soul guide when she somehow brings her friend back to life. After this, she is summoned by the Spider King to the Deadwood, where only her powers can tame the trees and restrain them from starting a war. So I tried to read this book during the power outage. It was one of my most anticipated releases from the whole year, and oh boy, is it letting me down pretty hard. About 40% of the way through it, what is that, like 177 pages? It has definitely been a while since I've touched this book. There are parts of it that have been enjoyable and have felt entertaining for me to read, but then there are also parts that have been dragging really bad, and it's honestly just not something that's like calling out to me to pick up again. I just don't know how much of those feelings are reading slump related or how much it is just this book disappointing me. I do plan to find out in September, but like I said, I'm not really in any hurry to pick this back up. So next I have Fairy Tail Volume 10. I did start, I got like I don't know, 1/4 of the way through. This will probably be one of the first things that I get back to. I only stopped reading it so I could pay attention to my actual TBR, which didn't really work out, but I did try. Next, I have Rebel of the Sands by Alwyn Hamilton. So this is a book that is set in a world that is very unforgiving to humans, especially if you're a poor, orphaned, or female. Our main character falls into all three of those categories, and she just wants to get out of her hometown before she ends up married or dead. She meets this guy, and then she sees him as the perfect escape route. So this book and I are actually having a pretty good time together despite all of the circumstances. It's been pretty fast paced, and I'm also just really curious to see where the story goes. The characters are fine. I do feel a little iffy about the romance, but I don't think it's going to be something that negatively impacts my reading. Like, I think it's something I can ignore pretty easily. I'm 149 pages through this, and I've already bought the rest of the series, so hopefully the last half of this book doesn't destroy my confidence here. The next is Summer Bird Blue by Akemi Dawn Bowman. So this book follows our main character Rumi, who loves to write music with her younger sister Leah. However, her sister ends up dying in a car accident. After this occurs, Rumi's mother sends Rumi away to live in Hawaii, and it is there that Rumi has to try to navigate her own losses and her own grief. Her goal is to just find her way back to making music while also trying to finish the song her and her sister never got to finish together. So I started this book towards the end of August, and I'm actually having a really good time with it. I have about 100 pages left. So there are two books I'm going to talk about next. I tried to start in between this book and Rebel of the Sands, and after those two, I was like, okay, maybe fantasies are the issue, and maybe a contemporary would be easier for me to read. So far, I would say that that statement feels pretty accurate right now. And that's not to say that this book is like an easy read at all. It's pretty sad and like major content warning for grief for sure, but it has been quick and I am liking it a lot. I'm probably gonna end up giving it 4 stars because I just haven't gotten like 5-star feelings from it yet, but I just do really appreciate this book and just all that it's done for me and getting me through my reading slump right now. So next I have Where Dreams Descend by Janella Angelis. So this follows the City of Ice as magicians face off against one another in order to win a headlining position in the Conquering Circus. Each act becomes more bold and more dangerous, and magicians begin to go missing, which leaves 3 of them to face their secrets before they go missing next. So this is a relatively new release. It came out towards the end of August, and I said in my August new releases that I'm pre-ordering video that if I was feeling good about where I was in my TBR, that I would start this book when it came out, which kind of the opposite ended up happening here, because when this book came in, I was just at such a loss with everything on my TBR that I was just like, why not try this? I'm 47 pages in, which not very far at all, but I do really like it so far, and I do think that this is giving me hope that I may be coming out of my slump soon. I'm definitely having a pretty good time with this so far. I'm liking the setting and the characters and the writing. I just see a lot of potential for this book and I am very excited to continue on with it. Next, I'm going to talk about those two books I started in between Rebel of the Sands and Summer Bird Blue. So first, I have Sea Fire by Natalie C. Parker. This follows a ship that has a crew of girls who lost all of their families and homes due to a corrupted warlord and his army. We follow our main character, who is the captain of the ship, and then they are helped by this guy who is a member of that army. This makes her question whether this boy really wants to help, or if he's a threat, or whether or not he is the key for taking down the warlord once and for all. So this book definitely got hit pretty hard by my reading slump. I read the first page of it, put it down, and then I just couldn't pick it back up again. I do really want to read this because I do love an ocean setting, and I'm also excited to read like a female pirate adventure. At least I think they're pirates. That's just always something that I've assumed about this book and about this series. I'm not actually 100% sure on that. Yeah, there's honestly not much to say here. Like, I haven't even added this book to Goodreads yet because my progress just isn't worth noting, so let's just move on. So next I have The Deep by River Solomon and some others who will be up on the screen. So this is a novella based off of African folklore about African slave women who are thrown overboard by slave owners, and then this follows the water-dwelling descendants of those women. So this is pretty short, so it has that working in its favor. I actually did try to start this book in August because I was like, I can finish it. It's a novella and it gets good ratings, so I'll probably love it too. And then I read like 30 pages of it and I retained very little of it. So when I do eventually pick this back up again, I do feel like I'm definitely going to have to start this over. I stopped reading this because at the time I just didn't feel like I was able to give it the proper attention and proper appreciation, so I definitely want to make sure that I'm completely out of my reading slump the next time I pick this up. So that's the last of my currently reading. Basically, I really only have one book that's working out right now, with a couple that I do have some confidence in, of course, but I don't want to get my hopes up too high yet. I don't know what it is about contemporaries. I feel like they're working out so well right now. I guess because they're just like a lot easier for me to read read and also faster. Honestly, at this point, I'm just not going to complain about it, so I will definitely be working on all of those in September, but I'm also going to be trying to start these next books I'm going to be talking about. So first I have If I'm Being Honest by Emily Wipperly and Austin Siegman Broca. So this follows our main character Cameron, who is a popular girl at her private high school who has a reputation for being brutally honest. However, one day she says something in front of her crush that makes her feel like she may have ruined her chances with him forever, so she decides to follow Shakespeare's Taming of the Shrew and tames herself. And she does this by making amends with everybody who she has wronged over the years, and this leads her to a guy named Brendan. And when she meets Brendan, her circumstances change, and this makes Cameron reevaluate not only what she's doing with him, but also just with her life. And then I also have The Gravity of Us by Phil Stamper. So this book follows our main character Cal, who is a popular social media journalist. He and his family are thrust into a huge media crisis when they make the move from Brooklyn to Houston when his father is selected for the NASA mission to Mars. It is in the middle of all of this that Cal meets Leon, and their romance and connection evolves just as fast as all the craziness surrounding the mission. The secrets regarding the mission begin to get uncovered, and Cal must figure out how to reveal this information without hurting the people that he cares about. So I've been trying to read these books for like the past 2 months now, so I will definitely be prioritizing these two. And like I said before, contemporaries really seem to be working out for me. If this reading slump continues throughout September, like throughout a lot of it, I definitely may be targeting only contemporaries, so there may just be more than these two from this genre, but we'll see how it goes. So next I have An Enchantment of Ravens by Margaret Rogerson. So this follows our main character who paints portraits for the fair folk. However, when she receives her first royal customer, she accidentally paints mortal sorrow into his eyes, which could cost him his throne and his life. He takes her to the courts to stand trial for what she did, but then they are constantly being attacked along their journey, so it's up to them to defeat whatever is wrong and rely on one another for survival. So this is another one that is relatively short, so I do think that it has like a good chance of succeeding under the circumstances, and I also do typically like books with fae in them. I also really love Sorcery of Thorns by this author, so I'm hoping that love continues on in here. So finally in this video, we have The Extraordinaries by TJ Klune. So this is an Own Voices debut that follows our main character Nick, who is a popular fanfiction writer for this superhero group. After an encounter with his superhero crush, Nick sets out to make himself extraordinary. So this is one that I've considered picking up multiple times now to try to break my slump, but I just don't want to risk it because it's supposed to be like Fangirl meets Renegades and I'm so hyped for it. So reading it while I don't really feel like reading, I just don't want that to be the reason why this book disappoints me, which I don't think this book is going to disappoint me, but if I don't end up enjoying it, I don't want my reading slump to be the reason why that happens. But I'm also just like really excited for this, and I may be coming out of my reading slump soon, so I honestly don't know how much longer I can hold off on this, but I definitely do want to play it safe. But at the same time, I definitely do feel like it's a book that could break me out of my reading slump, so I don't know, we'll see. So that is for the most part what I am trying to accomplish here in September. Usually I can just force myself to read through my slumps, but this one's bad. So I feel like I just have to wait this one out, which I hate doing, but it's just how this is going. And it's also about to be the fall, and I've been prepping all year for fall reads, and they're all just ready to go. So it's definitely time to get all these books read before that, and also since I picked a lot of these for summer reads, and I don't know how much summer weather is left. Also, one last thing, I don't really know when this video is gonna go up, because I do have my 8 a.m. right after I film this video, and then after that I have a 9:30, and then after that I do feel like I have a lot of work to do. I do plan on having regular Wednesday and Sunday uploads after this video, but like I said in the beginning, my plans have just been really turned upside down recently. But anyway, that is going to be it for today's video. Thank you all so much for watching. Like, comment, subscribe, hit the bell, and answer the question that'll be around here if you want to do that. And hopefully I will see you here next time. Bye!